manifesto, Dumaguete City Mayor Felipe Ipe Remolio. Good morning, Mayor. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Kat. Good morning, televiewers.
All right, sir. Mayong buntag, sir. Right now, consultations there with the Commission on Elections are ongoing. What is the prevailing sentiment among your constituents? Ano po yung mga napag-usapan this week in the past 3 days when the COMELEC began considering or asking your constituents if they want to postpone the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections in the province?
Well, unfortunately, while the consultations were being conducted, most of the barangay officials concerned are now in Manila with having their yearly conference or convention. But some officials, including the clergy, have already written or put into writing their sentiments, their position on the proposed postponement only of the barangay and SK elections only in Negros Oriental. So the 9 mayors who signed the petition or the position paper have already submitted this for public scrutiny, and this is not a verified petition to COMELEC. We are just saying, first of all, we are thanking the initiative of COMELEC through its chairman, Chairman Garcia, for conducting these public consultations. We are hoping that motu proprio under the motu proprio meaning at the initiative of COMELEC, it can postpone or suspend elections in any part of the country by virtue of its powers in as stated in the Omnibus Election Code, Batas Bilang 881, Section 5 in particular.
Apo. Sir, we do know that in the manifesto you signed together with other Negrense mayors, you mentioned that the alleged mastermind in the killing of Governor De Gamo remains intact, or his machinery remains intact, creating an atmosphere of fear and intimidation in our community. Himayin natin to, sir, no? What do you mean by that? Can you give us concrete examples on what is happening in Negros Oriental that causes fear among your constituents?
Well, initially, no. I mean, I would say that the case or the cases filed against the suspected mastermind and the actual perpetrators by direct participation are still pending with the Department of Justice. In fact, sadly, the person who is now out of the country has been taunting the responsible government officials like the DILG, DOJ, even Speaker Romualdez, including now the president. It's very unusual for a suspect. We call him suspect as of today. Pending the resolution of the Department of Justice. Very unusual for this individual to challenge, to taunt even the highest position of the country, a person holding the highest position of this country. And that in itself is a manifestation that he is confident that capable of capable of any force or violence that has driven the people of Negros Oriental confused, of driven by fear and uncertainty. And in fact, 2 days ago, just yesterday, another potential barangay candidate was gunned down in Barangay in by a one. So I don't know if it has already reached the national media.
Okay,
but yes, it was just got down from a public event.
All right, sir, tell us more about this incident, this barangay candidate who was gunned down in one of your villages there in Dumaguete City. What happened there, sir? Have you established a motive for the killing? Is it directly linked to the upcoming elections?
Kat, no. Let me correct you there. It's not in Dumaguete,
okay.
But in Barangay Malabugas, Bayawan.
Oh, in Bayawan. Okay.
He was gunned down in broad daylight by a riding in tandem individuals, and he was this guy came from a public event. He was hosting a public event, and he's very active in barangay affairs. And in his Facebook, you can see that he has intentions of running for barangay position come October 30, if this will proceed.
Mm-hmm.
So, and many other killings, barangay officials have been gunned down, not just in Bayawan, but in other parts of the province, including Dumaguete, which have all been unresolved.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the series of events that we feel that could qualify the suspension of elections because of violence, terrorism, maybe loss of and other analogous cases which can empower the COMELEC to suspend elections in any part of this country.
All right. Mayor, in Dumaguete City alone, would you have a ballpark figure of around how many individuals have been killed in recent days or weeks in the run-up to the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections?
Frankly, none in this period, but in maybe 3-4 years ago, there was a barangay official gunned down. But in the other parts of the province, this has been continuing, and all unresolved, and still people still fear that the PNP and the armed forces have not fully, have not fully controlled the situation.
Mm-hmm. And what about
especially that the suspect, the main suspect, is out of the country and he's still free to roam. He still has the resources. He's still free to even attack the institutions of the government. So that means dependency of the cases with the DOJ still is hanging, and we don't know when this will be resolved. You know, what if this will be resolved at or the time of the elections? We fear that either party, whether the supporters of the victims or supporters of the suspects would do when the Department of Justice hands down its verdict. So very volatile ang situation. It may seem that there are no killings now, except for the recent killing yesterday. There are still remnants of the groups. They're still in the Philippines, particularly in Negros Oriental, judging from the incident yesterday.
Mayor, what about the voters? Have they reported any incidents of intimidation, of violent campaigning from certain camps or groups in Negros Oriental who are gunning for a position in the BIA in the barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections?
I have no personal knowledge of that, but it's technically election period has not started, and there are no candidates yet to speak of.
Mm-hmm.
So it's too premature to say that these are election-related incidents.
All right, but sir.
Yes.
Mayor, the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections is not automated. Are there fears from your camp or from your constituents that during election day itself, the integrity of the ballots may not be secure enough due to, as you mentioned, certain violent events happening in the city?
In the province, you mean? No?
Oh.
The essence of this the call for suspension or postponement of the elections really based on the strong possibility of any violence now, judging from the past violence, by reason of the pendency of very serious charges of multiple murder, perhaps terrorism, imagine terrorism, which was mentioned by the Department of Justice, illegal possession of firearms, and these serious violations, or rather charges, would have its resultant effect on the conduct of our local elections, because for the past years we have been the people fear that there are political bullies in the province, and resulting to various crimes which have up to date not been resolved.
And why is the government incapable of addressing those political bullying, as you mentioned?
That is why we thank the government of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. for really galvanizing, using all the agencies of government to maintain peace and order, and to address this long bothering issues and concerns that have sowed fear and in Negros Oriental as a whole, as a province.
And why is that not yet enough, Mayor? What else does the province need for it to say that voters, that your constituents, already feel safe to cast their votes for the Barangay and Sangguniang Kabataan elections? What else needs to be done?
We feel that, first of all, the ratio between police and the number of population, which is ideally 1:500, or 1:800, has not been met, no? Ideally, in other words, kukulangin kami ng police. Kulang na ang police ratio-wise, police and population. Now, if you conduct the elections nationwide simultaneously, including the province of Negros Oriental, kulang na kami ng police. So we want a situation whereby the COMELEC and the PNP and all other enforcement agencies of government, including the AFP, to concentrate on to reinforce and or augment their forces in the province, so much so whatever fears, whatever possible untoward incidents that may happen due to the resolution of the pending serious violent crimes that have been now pending with the COMELEC, rather with the Department of Justice, would have been resolved.
Mm-hmm.
So in effect, this is just this will be a practical move, so that we will restore confidence in the voting, in the election process, by ensuring honest, orderly, and free elections. Because as of the moment, the ratio again between the number of police men and the population are not yet been met in any of the, in all the NGOs in the province.
Mm, so Mayor,
kung matapos na yung national sa ibang probinsya, now we can ask for augmentation, so that we will feel free, the people will feel free and safe, and proceed with the election.
Okay, Mayor, what's the current police to civilian ratio in the province?
I was told yesterday that it's about 1:1,000.
And what is the ideal number for you?
The ideal is 1:500.
Okay, so you want it doubled?
Yeah, practically doubled. No, so that in itself is a setback. More so with the conduct of elections that need augmentation from the neighboring provinces or neighboring cities of Negros Oriental.
Okay, so do you have already a proposed date on when you want to hold the BSK elections in the province?
In the event that COMELEC can see the wisdom of our proposal and it actually postpones the elections, the Omnibus Election Code provides that the postponement, the elections should be conducted after the postponement should not be far from the date of actual national elections and actual elections nationwide. So mga 2, 1, or 2, 3 months from the cessation of the violence or the fear. So ganon, it should not be far from the cessation or when these concerns have died down or have been controlled.
Sir, so safe to say you're amenable to still holding it this month, but just not simultaneous with the other provinces and cities in the Philippines.
You mean to say October 30?
Yes, sir. The date for the entire country is October 30. Are you still amenable to moving the barangay and sangguniang kabataan elections in your province still within the year, just not October 30?
It's possible because I understand that the cases, the serious cases against the suspects who are themselves are noted politicians in the province would have been resolved, and we will know by then whatever reactions, pro or con. I'm not saying that the violent reaction would come from the suspects, but maybe supporters of the victim should the DOJ decision would not be favorable to the victims. So when that happens, maybe 1 or 2 months after, then we will know if people have the propensity to do violence because of the decision. Then the COMELEC can readily say that, oh, tapos na yung, okay, may decision na, tapos na yung fear. Now we can now start with the postponed or actually it's a special elections for Negros Oriental.
All right,
it can be a month or 2 months or 3 months.
All right, and Mayor, finally, what are barangay and sangguniang kabataan candidates in the province saying? Would they not be at a disadvantage because, as things are already, those who will be winning in the October 30 polls will only have a 2-year term? Hindi po ba sila lugi if you keep on postponing the polls because they will then have a shorter term there?
You're right in that aspect, but you know, there's also a saying that goes, "Better safe than sorry." It's a shorter term rather than violence, and it will affect the entire province or perhaps the entire country. I personally think that saving lives is better than the shortening of the term of the officials. You're correct. The recent decision of the Supreme Court says that to uphold the right of the people to elect and to observe the three-year term of the barangay officials and SK officials.
All right, and we will have to leave it at that for now. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Dumaguete City Mayor Ipe Remolio.
Thank you very much, Scott, and thank you for this interview.